reacting is Sue Sepping for quoting Tina So Ooze Feet or Tina So Equaling Out of His Neck Necky Sue's by Olaf and Olin. Like, in the link to the video will be the description below. Go and check them out. So let's get into this work in 3, 2, 1.
That's how you used to sit up. You used to do that. Now do it how you do now. Oh my goodness.
Yep.
Texas, ice, negative temperatures, lack of power, heat, pipes bursting. We heard from so many of you that live in Texas how crazy it was last week. I hope that this week things are looking a little brighter in Texas. We were praying for you guys. We were praying for y'all. Isn't that what you guys say?
I love the y'all.
Southern accent. So Justin is in Texas for work for a couple of days. He gets home late Thursday night and heads out early Friday morning to go to Denver with Turin. So I'm going to be holding down fort for the next 5 days. It's going to be so much fun. Today is our busiest day. I had to be in 4 places at once, so I haven't even gotten on the camera yet today because let's just say sometimes it takes a village. Somebody helped me get Ashton home from school. I had to drop Turin off at someone's house so he could hang out there before his soccer carpool picked him up. Dropped Ava off at dance, got her a ride home from dance. We are just getting to therapy for Landon after school. It's pretty fun taking him to physical therapy right now because we are having so many firsts. So many, look what I could do before, look what I can do now.
Yep.
I don't think you could wipe the smile off of my face or Landon's every time that we discover something new that he can do. It is, the excitement is just through the roof right now. Videoing a lot of his physical therapy for the next little while, and I'm not apologizing about it because it is so exciting to see his body doing things that it has never ever done before. In fact, we're gonna have to find some cool side-by-sides, some cool before and afters. 9 more days in his cast, and then he's gonna be feeling even better. I think the cast is great because it's holding his foot, but it's also heavy, a little bit awkward, so it's just gonna keep getting better and better.
Yep.
Huh, Lando?
Yep.
I have 16 more days because, plus a week.
True. He's gonna have it on for another week or so while his braces are being made. Still not too bad, though.
Nope.
Devin and I are boarding here in just a few minutes. Quick little update. So, many of you are new to the channel. Opinion is a software company that helps generate consumer feedback by way of reviews, surveys, etc. So, we are off to Dallas to meet with a handful of clients and advisors.
Dallas! Yeah!
Partners that will actually help our business grow. We've got about 30 employees. So I've known Devin now for 8 years, roughly?
Yeah.
8 years. This is our first time going to business together, but we've had a wonderful, wild ride the last 4 years. And many more great things to come for Opinion. So if you guys are curious about what we do, go to opinion.com. You can check it out right now.
You can sit up without bending your knees. That is incredible. Look at you. Just showing off.
Just showing off. Yep.
It's only been 2 weeks. I know, he's so tall. Doesn't he just look so tall? But then he's also standing up so much straighter.
Yeah.
So that's part of it too, yeah, you know?
Yep.
Yep. So Landon and I are going to sneak up to Torrance soccer practice. It's really far away, but we don't get to see his games in Denver this weekend. As you know, this is Torrance's second day back to soccer practice. Yesterday was just drills. This is his first time playing soccer with contact. So I want to go make sure that he's doing well up there. We're just excited to watch him. You know Lando. It's one of his favorite things in the whole world to see Torrance play soccer. Plus, Landon has officially gotten the go-ahead from his physical therapist ditch the walker for part of the day. He's going to take the walker to school so that he doesn't get knocked over, and because he's supposed to be using it for the most part for the first month, but he, once he's done with school, gets to walk around without his walker, and it kind of feels like freedom to him.
Freedom, yeah.
And I think he's starting to feel a lot more like himself.
Limping when it's
much tougher than I am.
Alright, guys, I'm about to head to bed, but I wanted to give you a little update on Nala. I actually got a phone call on the way home tonight. She got all the lab results back. For those who are new here, our cat Blitzen died in October. Blitzen and Nala are from the same litter, both 14 and a half. We lost Blitzen to kidney failure last October. Nala was having some symptoms. We kind of wanted to get ahead of it in hopes that we could catch it before anything had progressed as far as it had for Blitzen. So we took her in, got some blood tests. Her symptoms were she was losing her hair, she was howling at night, and she has lost 4 pounds in the last few years. So they got the test results back. The veterinarian did indeed find some things that are going on. Thankfully, nothing is serious, but Nala has hypothyroidism, which the vet was suspecting. Hypothyroidism pretty much describes all of the symptoms that she was having. I was hesitant thinking that she wouldn't have that because Blitzen was tested for that many times with all of the same symptoms, and his results always came back normal. But she is definitely coming back with hypothyroidism. So they are going to treat that. They are going to give us a medication for her that will help her thyroid to get back to functioning normally. She should be feeling a lot better. Her symptoms should go away. On top of that, though, she is showing some signs and symptoms of kidney problems. Now, thankfully, she's not in kidney failure. She is nowhere near where Blitzen was when we took him to the vet about 3 days before he died. He was in such a sad condition by the time that we caught it with Blitzen, but she is having just the very, very beginning signs of having some kidney issues. So we're going to put her on a kidney diet. She's also showing some signs of having a possible infection. So we're going to give her an antibiotic. We're going to put her on a kidney diet. We're going to get her the medication for her hypothyroidism, and Nala should be feeling a ton better. She obviously is 14 and a half years old. We don't know how many more years we get with her, but she said for the most part that she's doing very well. She's a pretty healthy cat for a 14 and a half year old cat. And hopefully by giving her some of these treatments, she will not only feel better, but we will be able to help her to live a longer, healthier life. So honestly, overall, pretty good news. Most of all, just so happy that we figured it out now rather than when it's too late. So I know a lot of you were so sweet when we sent out that video about Nala. I'm gonna go tomorrow, pick up everything we need for her, and get her on the road to feeling better. Guys, thanks for hanging out with us today. As you can tell, after a pretty crazy winter, things are looking up over here. Turin's improving, he's getting back into soccer.
Landon
is looking and feeling better than he has his entire life. The sun is shining over here at the Bingham House. Thank you so much for all the love and support. Thank you for watching. Make sure you smash that like button.
Yes, one more like.
Make sure you have subscribed to our channel if you have not already. We are on the road to 100K. We are getting so close. We're
and
so excited.
Subscribe if you didn't already. Sue sipping for quoting TSO U speed or TSO equaling of is Nike Sue's by Olaf and Olin. A link to his video will be the description below. Go and check him out. And drop a like if you like. And comment down below if you want to see more reactions like this one. And subscribe if you're new. And click the bell to be notified when I upload. No matter. Bye.